WeServe's Fireside Chat, which is going to talk about mobile marketing in 2018, the marketer's wish list. Now, for this Fireside Chat, I'd like to call forward a gentleman who, after having launched multiple market-first initiatives for Yahoo India, pioneered mobile internet portals for telecom operators, co-founded mobile marketing and commerce platform WeServe in the year 2010. In 2015, he co-founded VMAX with the aim of solving the unmet challenge of app publishers. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome the co-founder and CEO of WeServe and VMAX, Mr. Deepak Khurana. Thank you for joining me. Now, joining him for this conversation is the gentleman who started his career with Future Group in the year 2000 and was a part of the group's journey of becoming a 15,000 crore empire, where he played a very pivotal role in building the Big Bazaar, Pantaloons, E-Zone, Hometown, and of course, the most fashionable FBB brand. After retail, ladies and gentlemen, his next stint was in housing at Tata Housing, where he pioneered the organization's first step towards the use of the fastest growing digital platform as well as homes online by creating the first of its kind selling of homes through Google, Facebook, Snapdeal, and therefore completely revolutionizing the real estate industry. In his current role at Future Group, he has a similar mandate to bring in the digital revolution to the group. Please help me welcome the group head, Digital Future Group, Mr. Pawan Sardar.
Okay. Hi, everyone. The couple of sessions in the morning before were very interesting, especially the one from Neeraj. It left me on such a big high that the moment I stepped out, I was searching for a paperboat drink. I could not find it. So just to settle on that, I ended up saying that, no, instead of coffee, let me have the most authentic India drink, which is the Indian chai. Yeah. So interesting. Okay, pulling back, this event, you know, when you speak about Tech Munch, the first initiative here, I've known the team at Exchange for Media for so many years, and their platform is something which always has been working towards celebrating Digital India. And we've been doing that for the last 6-7 years. Very exciting time today in 2017, where the whole internet ecosystem is looking so massive, just in terms of sheer size, the number of companies, the number of people in the ecosystem who are so curious about it, that it just gets all of us together out here to exchange notes. So when the team approached us and we said that, look guys, here is an opportunity where the industry is going to come together, do you want to probably really talk about something? At that point of time, I said that, look, you know, there is a lot happening in the ecosystem. How do we really, you know, whilst we all work in silos, we all understand, you know, what is playing out, we have our own strategies, but finally, you know, we are talking about here the marketer, we are talking really about saying that, look, digital is evolving rapidly. Let us probably get into the minds, you know, of a leading marketer. Let us understand, you know, what is he thinking about, you know, in terms of where it is today and how it will unfold. And hence probably, you know, this theme out here of a fireside chat. So Pawan, welcome.
And thank you.
Thank you so much for taking time out for this piece. So let me start off, you know, probably, Pawan, it would be helpful if you can, you know, just quickly tell, you know, what are you doing at Future Group?
Okay. Firstly, I think great crowd, yeah, to see everybody here and listening to us. So I'll tell you what, we are in the business of retail. One of the mandate which we see for the country is also to create consumption in the country and for the ecosystem, and therefore create many reasons, many occasions where I think people can buy, consume, and that's how we look at our business, firstly. Therefore, what becomes important in today's world is therefore digital. Why does it become important? Because I believe that, you know, if you need to engage with young India, this medium is important. I don't think we can ignore it. And that's what we are doing. So therefore, the mandate which me and my team, we carry is how do we create, for all our formats and brands, how do we create reasons to engage with our audience? How do we create, consumption from this medium? And also, lastly, create conversion. It's just not about conversation. So one big mandate which we have taken as a team is conversion as well. So the reason I'm stressing on this point is many a times I hear marketeers talking about, let's do engagement, let's do various things. But for us, I think ultimately, if you put the tough task of saying, how do we create conversion, that's important. And that's what we do.
Sure. So, I'm going to come back to that word convergence very quickly. When we look at Future Group, it is a multi-format retail strategy. So many brands in the food space, in the fashion space, in the home space. So for the externally, for the digital ecosystem, who are creating various kinds of solutions, we are quite curious to understand that how is it that you tackling digital marketing in this group?
Okay, so I think one important thing is it's not about digital marketing. I think it's marketing in the digital world, firstly.
Great point.
So, therefore I think, at least I feel that there's no discussion about saying digital or no digital. Like you are in this world and you better do something about it, right? So, and that's how we see things, and therefore we are a very consumer-driven organization. We always put consumers forefront, upfront, right? Where are they? What are they doing? What's their need gap? What can we address it maybe as a product, maybe as something else? But it's always consumer first in our organization, right? So when you put consumer first, therefore, one of the medium which I think the consumers, our consumers, are consuming is digital. Therefore, it becomes important. The point is now, what do you do with it, right? You can create your campaigns. What you usually do and extend it there, we don't do that for sure. We create campaigns here. When I'm loosely using the word campaigns, it's also to say
so you
reasons
end up
for,
creating yeah. campaigns first for digital.
Absolutely, absolutely,
and
absolutely.
And why do you do that?
So I think this medium is unique. It's a act and interact medium, where one doesn't need to go and review after 3 months and say what's happened. Let's look at the campaign.
Sure.
I think this medium tells you in 3 hours what's going on.
When did you start doing this?
A year back,
2 years back?
Actually, we became very serious somewhere in mid of 2016.
Interesting.
That's where we realized that this medium just cannot be ignored.
So you forced the organization to go ahead. Can I say that?
So, yeah.
Did you have to like put a lot of weight saying that, look, I am going to probably make digital campaigns first?
I don't want to say that we forced the organization. I think we brought the conviction up front. And we said that I think this medium can deliver for us. And one important thing is put your neck out and say, listen, if we do it, I think it can deliver to the business. And the point is create some of the case studies, right? It's very, very important. Ultimately, I don't think any of the CEOs are going to agree to your point just because it's a sexy medium. They're not going to agree to your point. Put your neck out and create it for them. The moment if they start seeing conversion, as I said, they will do what, you want to do.
Do you want to probably share some examples which you probably feel, is something which went viral within the organization itself, which,
oh my God,
because it's a multi-brand, right? You could have had early adopters and there could be some people on the fence saying that, look, no, let the other brand try it.
Yeah. So So let me give you one example which we did, and I think how I was so amazed about the way our organization kind of got excited and did various things. I mean, I can virtually, you know, write a book on it, but it was very interesting, to very overwhelming, more importantly. So you know, in FBB we had a category shorts, which we believe that I think India is consuming, and there's a lot more which can happen, right? So I think we started wearing denim just about 15 years back. You know, chinos are just about we are wearing right now. And they're replacing a lot of, you know, formal pants and so on and so forth. As India is getting younger, I think shorts is something, if you go to a mall today, right, you'll see many people wearing it, right? If you go for a movie, you'll see many people wearing it. So we saw a huge opportunity out there and said, how can we actually create another denim of shorts, basically? You know, how can it be such a big category? So while we spoke to the business team, you know, we realized that digital is an absolutely apt medium for it, right?
Sure.
Why would I go and do Times of India ads for shorts, right? Who's my audience? The audience is somebody who's young in his mind. Yeah, I don't want to bracket it and say from an age perspective, but more from young in mind, right? So we said, okay, let's only do digital. I don't have my agency here. They were just here with me a few minutes back. But I think they came back with a fantastic campaign. They said, let's call it World Shorts Day, right?
Interesting. So I'm keeping an eye on the time, and I want to make the most of it. I'm going to jump quickly to the next point that, okay, great stuff to hear. Digital first, 2016 is the first time your organization ended up doing that. Okay, today when you look at it and you say 2018, right? What is the one thing which comes to your mind saying that, listen, can this ecosystem solve this problem instantly?
See, one of the way in which I look at this ecosystem is...
Especially the mobile marketing ecosystem.
Sure. So, you know, in my head, it's always mobile. I don't even think anything else.
Great.
If you ask me. Like, I think that's how the audience is reacting, and that's how they do things. One, you know, differentiator in which we look at the medium is, I think, there is a push medium when I see television and rest of them. I think this is a pull medium.
Okay.
The point is, as a marketeer, how am I being part of their journey when they are looking for me or they are trying to figure something out? So I think as long as we change the lens and try and be as part of the pull medium, I think a lot of it can be answered and a lot of it can be resolved. So that's how we look at it. We want to be part of the pull medium.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Okay. Talk about... What comes to your mind when you hear the word data?
I think it's everything. Yeah, I mean, today's world, if you look at in the kind of business which we are in, right? We literally sell food to electronics, to clothes, to everything, right? So it's very important to be sharp with your audience. I think that's what the data is going to...
Do you think the ecosystem is coming to you with richer data offerings today?
Not really. I think, you know, there's a lot of discussion which happens on data, but I think sometimes the kind of, I think maybe a profile which you're looking at, the kind of audience which you're looking at, sometimes we don't get it as sharp as that. So we land up again going and spraying everywhere.
Are you saying that the local market is really data poor in that sense? India, you know, generally when it comes to mobile marketing, are we data poor or are we data rich?
I'm not too sure about being data poor or data rich. It's about reading the data. I think that's where we are slightly poor at.
Sure.
So I think there's enough and more data. Sure. I don't think that's a problem, but I think it's about reading the data right.
Sure.
I think that's where a lot can be done.
Yeah, interesting. You know, data is such an important subject in the ecosystem that we as a company, we've been working on it. And our vision was that, listen, let's bring telecom data, you know, for digital marketing,
right?
You know, so we put together a DMP in carriers like Vodafone and Idea. So imagine that you mentioned about E-Zone, right?
Right.
So what if you end up getting a data set like age of device, where you actually know that these are in-market smartphone buyers? Would something like that, you know, end up moving the needle for you?
See, absolutely. Like one of the things which the data can tell us, some sort of predicting about the customer will be very interesting, right? Because we are in the process, as I said, as a company, we believe in creating consumption. If I know that he could be a possible customer who could be the, who could take part in next level of his consumption idea, I think it'll be far richer for us to, you know, be far more sharper from a marketing lens. And yes, I mean, we would love to kind of be part of that ecosystem for sure.
Any recent examples where you've used data internally, like for any activity right now?
Yeah, so we do that. So we ourselves has a huge amount of data.
Absolutely, you have a lot of customer data.
Yes. So we are in the process of figuring it out in terms of segmenting the data right and so on and so forth. But that's again from a retail lens. I think we would always want to know a slightly broader lens from his consumption cycle where we can constantly be part of his journey.
Sure. Yeah. You know, talk about the moment we talk about data, and in many conversations when we have with leading marketers, you know, obviously marketers have X amount of data and partners could have another third-party data available, right? Do you see data collaboration as a key, you know, driver to probably make mobile marketing more effective? Because I probably find that when you engage with a marketer and you ask them that, listen, you have to share some data, you know, the moment you talk about data sharing, people kind of raise their eyebrows.
So my answer to that is, as long as the customer said, given his consent, we don't have any problem in terms of sharing it. But it has to be, the consent has to come from the customer. That's very important to us because we generally don't want to float his data, you know, just because of, you know, our needs and wants. The thing is, we are all customers, right? Nobody will like if somebody is trying to chase you, right? If the customer is fine with it, we don't have a problem in terms of making our data right and collaborating with anybody. That's not a problem ever.
Do you end up leveraging, because in the retail store, you collect tons of data, right? About users. Do you end up retargeting those customers digitally?
Absolutely.
You do that?
Absolutely.
Okay, so.
Absolutely. Oh. In fact, we create customer segment through the data. There are many a times, you know, there are some segment which become so tough. For instance, we have a brand called All, you know, which is a plus size brand. How do you figure that customer out?
Sure.
Where is that audience? It's very tough to figure that audience out. Sure. That's where we go back to our set. We go back and try and look up. So we do those kind of combination.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure. Great. So what is the, you know, one or two things which you would probably end up telling, you know, there are various companies out here who basically want to reach out to you and give you solutions.
Sure.
You know, so what could be those one or those two things which you would say that, listen, solve this problem for us?
Forecasting is one thing which comes to my mind immediately. Again,
forecasting of
the consumer.
Consumers.
And I think that's where, just not our data, that's where the digital ecosystem is going to help, right? Sure. If he's interacting in the digital ecosystem, I'm sure he's navigating, and therefore there can be something which can be read out about the customer and said, possibly this is what he's going to do. And that is exactly, we are open to collaboration, right? It needs to be meaningful for us and for the customer both. As long as that's there, you know, it's like we are most welcome about, you know, doing some of these things.
Sure. Interesting. I am going to, you know, probably pause here and open this for a couple of questions out here, guys. It's a fireside chat, hopefully. So if you have something to fire at Pawan, go ahead and do that. It's your opportunity. If you're trying to sell him something, you can go ahead and ask him.
My God.
Hi, good morning, Pawan.
Hi, good morning.
My question to you, my name is Anil Meghani. I represent Netcore Solutions. So as a marketer and as a head of the entire group, what is more vital for you? Is it acquisition? And when I mean acquisition, it's not only new customers to your brand, but it could be about the cross-selling within your group, which is there, or the engagement with your existing brand, existing customers. So what is more important? How are your marketing spends currently diverged between these two?
See, it's tough to prioritize this, but acquisition is something which will be very important to a market like India, if I say that, right? Because, you know, from a consumption level, I don't think, you know, compared to any of the country, look at China, we are nowhere. So acquiring a customer will always be the first priority, but I think cross-selling is smart, right? If you acquire somebody, if you're not able to cross-sell, then what's the point? What's the point of even having his data? Right? So I think in my head, there is no priority as such. I think it all needs to be done parallelly and keep learning out of it. right? So, but as I said, acquiring is must in a market like India.
There's a lady out there. Well, we'll just be taking one last question.
Hi.
Hi.
With the whole digital revolution coming up, how important you think is the quality of digital marketeers and digital agency important? And how important you think is training coming into picture to make sure that we have quality digital marketeers?
I think that's a very interesting question which you've asked. I don't know about quality or not quality. What I'll go for is intent, right? What is the intent you're carrying? So we work with various number of agencies across the digital ecosystem. I've come across people who just come and want to replicate things, right? I don't think it's going to ever work in a market like India, right? I think what's your intent and what's the objective? If you have partner which actually share this vision, please go ahead and work with them. That's what we do, right? And if somebody is just trying to create case studies and, trying to, impress you with case studies across the globe and trying to do it here, trust me, it's not going to work. So I go back and actually look at the intent. If the intent is right between two partners, I think there can be magic which can be created. And we've done that with our partners in last 6 months. Is that the last one?
Yep, that should be.
Sorry. Yeah. Do you have an in-house team, and how often do you all train the team, or is training playing an important role in that?
Of course, we have a large team of young guys. Some of them are here, so of course, bunch of energy with them, and that's exactly where they bring in a lot of fresh ideas because they don't carry maybe a legacy like maybe I would carry, right? So, of course, their input is very, very important in terms of, what they do and what we drive within the organization. That goes, without saying. So, yeah.
Thank you.
Fantastic. I think that's all the time we have,
unfortunately. Thank you so much.
Pawan, thank you so much for sharing your insights with us. And Deepak, thank you so much for facilitating this conversation. Deepak, I'm going to request you to kindly present a memento to Pawan for talking to us this afternoon.
Thank you so much, everyone. I think one takeaway from my side is whenever we are having conversations with people like Pawan and we are saying that, listen, the market is moving towards people-based marketing. Yeah. So the sooner you get there, the better, because we are at a point where organizations, if they don't do people-based marketing or they don't have solutions around that, they're probably going to be irrelevant at some point. Yeah. Okay. So on that note, I want to say thanks to Pawan.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sirs.